Hello Gundam fans, this is Brad92, and today I'll be looking at the 100 Master Grade Gundam Eclipse. And I got the mock here from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So hey, we got a brand new seed kit in a series that I think takes place between Seed and Destiny. Makes sense, I think it's like 3 or 4 year gap, they can totally do stuff, and I'm sure they have more. And this is the mobile armor mode, and you do get the black stand, which is nice, because to have this you do want to have something displayed in. It's okay. I do find the wings don't like to peg in and hold very well. In fact, not a lot of this likes to hold very well. The feet come unpegged very easily. The arms kind of peg from the shoulders very easily. I find mine at least likes to droop in the chest. They tried. It's not just the wing gun no more. Newer forms of Zeta, where you basically just rotate the waist, bend the knees forward. So they tried to do something different. It kind of looks like, to me, Megatron from Transformers Cybertron, I think it is. Kind of like that, futuristic, like, give some wheels, it could be a race car thing. Little baby wings, it's a thing, they tried. I do like the pegs for the stand connector in the back. It's a very good connection, although I don't like the fact you have to take off a piece of the armor in order to actually utilize a stand. So I'm not a huge fan of that. And then you just take this little fin thing and bring it forward, because you can't have it when the kid is on the stand. So you got that. It's a thing. Now transformation is not too complicated. You got what I initially thought were the feet. It's just like the foot armor. You want to make sure the side parts are spread out. And then you got the back piece, which can rotate. I like how they have the one on the top, one on the bottom. That was an interesting idea. You want to bring this whole back piece down, which brings the front part up, and then you can clip it inside. And then you got the little tootsie. And that's one of the legs all done. So when you have the lower half all done, well, we'll get this folded back into his butt, and then you can get the side skirts down, bring up that torso piece, also bringing down the crotch piece, which will peg the back skirt into the crotch, which will keep it secure if I can get in the right position, that would help. And then it's a matter of getting the arms all fixed. Which, it's not super complicated, because you just like untap those. I like the fact that the hands are actually left on the model. That's cool. And then just kind of bring the joints and the arms forward. Then we can rotate the shoulder in, which is a cool little addition. I like that. Get those wings down there, these little pieces. And that's the arm all done. So finally, we can bring up the head on a double joint, and then bring back the chest, which, yeah, these little light panels here on the sides of the chest are kind of annoying. You want to make sure you get them spread out away from the chest armor so you can actually get it past these pieces of breaking something. Alright, once you lock the neck into the chest piece, it's a matter of rotating the top of the head around and then just collapsing it down. And that is the 100 Master Grade Gundam Eclipse in its interesting bubble suit mode. That is for sure. It's interesting proportions, that's for sure. It's got a real weird design, I feel. It's, on a glance, it might not look too bad, but once you start looking at it, I feel it's odd. Especially, I can't get over these baby feet. I initially thought these parts here were the feet, these big protrusions. They kind of look like it. I mean, it does stand, so I guess it's not that bad, but it's just really weird. I guess it's okay. Got these big pieces hanging off here. The head is interesting. It has kind of like a moonwort look to it, I feel. With a very decorative V-fin. So, yeah, it's unique. You do get decals, just peel, of course. And the foil stickers, which I just used for the cameras, the eyes are clear plastic, so I left that. It does have a cockpit inside with this piece here. Actually, the cockpit's down there. But it's a pain to get to, and I don't want to touch anymore. So for the articulation, it's okay. We got the ball-jointed head. The arms, I do want to mention, make sure you push the shoulder piece in to lock it in place so it doesn't try to rotate it on its own. It keeps the arms in place, which is good. Because they are very tight. You do have some good double jointed. You can move the arm, you just have to contend with this piece in the front and the back. Not a huge deal. Ball jointed wrist. You have another ball joint up here. You have the ball jointed thumb with the swappable fingers. You got the... I guess you can use the transformation joint in the torso. It does still rotate at the waist, that's good. You got the front skirts, which are ball jointed. You got those side skirts, which can really get out of the way. The back skirts, you can move it, just be careful because it's going to unlock stuff. You got the hinge in the crotch that can come down. So legs can go out, forwards, and back, some rotate the thigh. You got a nice double jointed knee. The feet, well, they do have this little piece here that connects is annoying. But they can go forward and back some, they can tilt, they can rotate, and the toes can move. So, it's got good articulation for what it can do, it's just, I don't know, it's weird. Especially, my biggest complaint, I think, with this kit are these parts here. That clip going into that bar to hold the front and the back of the leg together just isn't solid enough. At least I don't think. Maybe other people have better luck. I don't know. So let's talk about the weaponry. And it mostly comes down to the parts on the side skirts, which I really like. Because you got like beam rifles, so you can unpeg it. And I like how they have a peg on either side of the rifle. So you can close them up nice and smooth. You got the handle. That'll come down. And it does have the swappable fingers, so you got the ones that can be held here. These ones are, I believe, more... Because you have ones for to use different accessories. Like, you got this one, I guess, is a little more trigger finger with the tab. Then you have ones for beam sabers and so on. Talk about a little more later. But it will hold them with the fingers. But really, I really think it's cool is that you can actually pull these out. And now you have a beam saber. That is really cool, having the beam saber handle, or the hilt, inside the rifle. Now, I don't know if this could be used on the side skirt, kind of like the Freedom, without the beam saber attached. I would assume it could. Because all it has to do is just like rotate forward, and boom. So I'm not really sure if that is what it can do or not. But I do like the fact that you can do that. And of course, you can still use the same hand with the peg, if you want. But you also have the normal holding ones. You have the split open hands. You got the closed fist ones. You also have ones that are meant to hold other accessories, like the launcher of the launcher strike. Because this thing can use backpacks from the strike, impulse, and the Zaku. Now for the strike, if you want to equip the shoulder armor, you do get these adapters, which are hinged. Which simply tab onto the top of the shoulders of the Eclipse. So you attach the launcher and the sword armor. However, I did test the sword shoulder armor from the Dragon Momoko strike. And they don't work because it has tabs that actually tab very securely onto the shoulder armor inner frame. And so you'd have to cut those off. But I liked it on the strike, so I'm not going to do that. But I think it will work if you just cut those tabs off. Now, you can also attach the packs. The backpack itself is designed to accept... Oh, it has a thruster there. But it's designed to accept normal striker packs. But, with parts it comes with, like this piece, which you just have to replace these covers, these ones are for the Zaku wizards. And these ones are for the Impulse. So you get pretty much any backpack. And I'll just show it off. I want to see, I haven't tested it out yet, I want to see if a third-party backpack, because we know the Bandai kits will work without a problem. And I figured, why not use the, one of the Makatsuki backpacks? Oops, no. But it should, theoretically, just slide in. Although we will have to move that out of the way, which is why it's there to move on a hinge. But it will connect, as you can see. So a third-party strike pack, or base on the strike, I should say, at least, will work with the Eclipse, which is good. And then you have these pieces here, because you can take effect parts that it comes with. Just gotta take off this yellow piece, pretty much. And you can attach the effect parts onto here. And there it is with the shield, and I guess it's also got like a beam dagger on the end. And if you want, you can remove these arm pieces and attach like the other striker parts, like the that sword strike grappling hook thing, shield. You can put it on there if you want. So it's got quite a bit of versatility to it, that's for sure. And of course you can still use the action base that it comes with. So before I'm finished, of course I want to compare it to another model. Here it is next to the Master Grade Revived Strike, or Remastered Strike. So you can see it's a very tall model kit, that's for sure. And that's the Gundam Eclipse. I don't know how I feel about it. I like the design. Even though it is a little lanky, I like it. It's different. Different is good. The mobile arm remote is also different. I kind of wish the wings were bigger, though. That would be a plus, I believe. Not a huge fan of these legs. These, I think, are the worst part of the kit. To me, anyways, they don't like to stay attached. Every time I try to move the leg or the foot, they unpeg. Very annoying. I love the beam rifles with the beam sabers built in. That's cool. The shield with the beam makes sense. They were going into that technology anyway, so it's cool that they incorporated. It's not a full beam shield, but it is cool. And the fact they can take basically any striker pack, including third-party ones, is definitely a good plus, and a lot of customizations. So that's about it. If you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.